pleasure to be here on such a day, such a night. My novel, Sins of a Younger Son, concerns, among other things, a love story of a woman. This scene takes place in 1994 in a coastal city in El País Vasco, Spanish Basque country. Shaken by her encounter with her husband, Peru, the ETA leader named Apostle Peter, he, Selena, came in a safe house in San Sebastian and found Luke lying on a sofa and reading a paperback in English. The sky had cleared and the afternoon was nearly gone when in a chipper voice she told him to put on good walking shoes and bring a light jacket. She wanted to go out for the evening, she said, and it would be breezy. Holding hands like the lovers they were, and the innocents they were not, they made their way up the Alameda. She led the collie off the leash there and watched him scatter birds at the end of the beach. Iselina called him back after a while, and they walked on along the shore beneath the steep and heavily wooded Monte Higueldo, which rose above the west end of the city and bay. They caught a funicular to the summit. There was an unused amusement park up there and the port's one time loud lighthouse. Iselina led them to a small bar with patio tables overlooking the bay. She gave Luke's cheek two fond pats and brought glasses of tinto fino and small plates of pinchos, the best tapas. She took the other chair and leaned over to stroke Bartolo's head. "I think he's your dog as much as mine now," she said. "Look how he's snuggled up against you." "If that's true, he doesn't have good sense either." He drank some wine and set the glass aside. Iselina touched a cleft in the web of flesh between forefinger and thumb of his left hand. "Why do you have that scar?" she said. "A guy stuck a knife through it one time." "Where?" "South America." "What did you do?" "I shot him with the other hand." He said nothing, just stared at him. The lobe-shaped Bahia de la Concha angled southeast into large parts of San Sebastian. Across the bay from where they sat on Monte Higueldo was a second heavily wooded promontory, Monte Regul, and there below them was the unpopulated but imposing Isla de Santa Clara. The promontory's an island that caused the tides to build two white sand beaches. The island divided the waves and sent them washing in concentric patterns toward the two beaches. Iselina said, "Look, it's like a part of someone's hair." None of the buildings strung along the bay and its beaches were high rises. The ones on the shorefront stood shoulder to shoulder, rebuilt of long stone in bell epic style. She told him that San Sebastian owed its look to Napoleon's attempt to make himself emperor of Europe, starting with Spain. He chose San Sebastian as his fortress, believing that with his cannons dug into two mountains, the English leader called the Duke of Wellington and his Portuguese and Spanish partisan allies could not possibly overrun the town. But the cannon fire from the ships overwhelmed the French artillery. And as a terrible fire consumed the town, the French soldiers fled. Napoleon lost thousands of men in a rout and pressed on to the debacles of the Russian invasion in Waterloo. The Basques rebuilt here as fast as they could, Isolina said. Isn't it ironic that they did it in the architectural style of the French? Luke said, I see why you love it here. It's beautiful. It's my home, or where I want it to be. He took a deep breath and said, Isolina, we need to talk. I thought we were. I know about the shootout, he said. Not much detail, just that someone was killed and Peru got away. After a couple of deep breaths, she cried, you come in here and sweep me off my feet. His laugh shot her from her chair. Wait, he said, reaching for her. Please wait. I'm sorry. Sit down. That's just so different from how I view myself. Who are you? A cop? A spy? At his silence, she shook her head. An American spy. I knew it. I knew it. Isolina, I read about the shootout today in a Spanish newspaper. It's over between those Americans and me. I didn't know a thing about you till I saw you on that Arab horse. Since then, it's been hard to think of anything else. So now I know, she said. You know, some of it. She pressed her fingers against her temples like a migraine was coming on. Is that the first time a woman's told you she's in love with you? Is that what you said? Are you going to make me say it again? No, I feel the same way. Say it then. You said it in Euskera, the language of the Basques. Nigmaiten, Zaitu. For once, he did something just right. She took his hands in hers. All right, I believe you. So what do we do? What do you do with me? We could just keep going. Where? Prague, Istanbul, Addis Ababa. She gave him a wry look. Addis Ababa. He shrugged. Somebody told me it's a good place. She said, I don't think I love you enough to go live there. She told the dog to scoot and gestured at Luke to move his chair out from the table. She sat in his lap and put her arm around his shoulder, her fingers playing with curls of his hair. With nightfall, the lights of the city sent dagger-shaped reflections reaching outward in vain. Far out past the Isle of Santa Clara in the deep water, the night dropped jags of lightning, just a passing summer storm. Thank you.